be honest for a second. Not every video I make will help you make money. Some of my videos will help you write a book. Some will encourage you during a difficult time. Some will teach you practical things that you can do to face your fears and doubts. Some will make you laugh. Some will be about Lego. Some will even give you parenting tips. I have a wider range of videos, but not every video that I make will help you make more money. They won't. But this one though, ooh, get ready. If you use the three words that I'll teach you in this video, you will make more money. How do I know? Well, because I've taught these three words to thousands of people and they work. Now, if I were you, I'd be real worried right now. I'd be thinking, he's about to pitch me something. Here comes a pitch. Nope. There's no course or curriculum or upsell coming at the end of this video. I don't have anything to sell you today. I don't. I just learned something 12 years ago that really helped my side hustle, and I think it'll really help yours. I'll never forget when my friend Megan caught up with me in a green room in Dallas, Texas, about a month after I shared these three words with her. Now, a green room is just a fancy way to say place where they keep free granola bars at speaking events. But Megan came up to me in the green room and she said, hey, I have to tell you, I tried that technique that you told me about and it made me $2,000. Three words, $2,000, that's a pretty sweet ROI. But enough about Megan. Let me start things off with a question that another friend asked me one day. My friend, who is an interior designer, once asked me, hey, John, how do you say no to friends who want you to work for free without hurting the relationship? How do you say no? Now that's an interesting question because it happens to so many people in so many professions. If you're a photographer, a designer, a developer, a writer, a personal trainer, a doctor, a mechanic, a hairstylist, a lawyer, an illustrator, or a billion other professions, friends are going to ask you to work for free. That will happen. I even know some homeschool parents who get asked to babysit during the day because, quote, you're already home. What's a few more kids? I'll just stick mine in the corner. You won't even notice them. It'll be great. Sometimes people describe that specific request as a play date. Wouldn't it be amazing if my kids played at your house from like 8 to 5, 5 days a week? That would be the best. The request to work for free often starts with an email that goes something like this. Hey, sorry to bother you, but I need your opinion on something. I need a quick logo. It should only take you a few minutes. You could probably knock it out in your sleep. Is that something you could help me with? I love your style. There are a few signs that you've just been asked to work for free in emails like that. Number one, the promise that it'll be quick. If someone ever says to you, I just need you to tweak it or tweak something, run. It's never just a tweak. Tweak is actually Latin for 40-year project. A lot of people don't know that. Number two sign, help me, is often code for give me something for free. And number three sign, there's usually at least one compliment in the email to soften you up a bit. Oh, you've got such a good eye. I love your eye. Sometimes the friend will promise you great exposure. Now, I'll do a separate video about that topic and what it means to work for exposure because it's not as cut and dry as you think. Or your friend will offer to barter something you didn't want or need. Hey, you take my photos and I'll let you have one of the albino ferret pups we have after albino ferret breeding season is over. I just tried to think of the worst barter I could come up with, and that's what I was able to come up with. I also like to use really obscure examples so that the internet doesn't get angry at me. I have to believe that the albino ferret community is very small and is not likely to see this video. I feel like I would be able to handle their very specific wrath. The email you receive might be different, but regardless of how the request is made, how do you handle it? What do you do in that moment? My old method was to say yes out of guilt and then do the work filled with pure, white, hot rage. My words said, sure, no problem, but my face said, I would kill you in your sleep if I owned a good pair of gloves. Have you ever done that? Have you ever said yes to something because you just didn't know how to say no, or you didn't want to disappoint somebody, and then you're furious with yourself? It's not a fun way to live. It's not a fun way to run a business. After years of doing that, I came up with a really simple plan in 2008. That's when I first started building a side hustle, and I started to expand my freelance writing and my speaking. I had all these things that were growing. And so the first thing you say when someone asks you to do some work for free are three magic words. They're so simple, you won't even believe they're magic, but I promise you they are. You should write these words down. If you're the notebook kind of person, if you're taking notes, which I like to pretend you are, you should write these down. Are you ready? Here's what you say when someone asks you to work for free. What's your budget? Those are the words. Let me repeat them because they're so simple and so fast you probably miss them. What's your budget? Now, this question works because it introduces money into the equation without being offensive. Instead of saying back to them, well, my hourly rate is $100 an hour, which puts your friend on the defensive, all of a sudden there's money there, you respond with an easy question. The question helps your friend remember that this thing you're doing, you're professional at. It quietly introduces the idea that you do this for a living or for a side hustle. You're serious about it. It reminds them that this is your job, not just a passion. We're not just talking about a hobby. You see, people sometimes get confused by this because for them, photography is a hobby. So why shouldn't it be the same for you? But just because you love to do something like photography doesn't mean you shouldn't get paid for it. Hey, you know how you love your camera, you shutterbug, you, oh, you're such a shutterbug. Wouldn't you love to spend your Saturday afternoon taking my kid's senior high photo? She plays the clarinet, so if you could scout out waterfalls in the area that would look great with a clarinet, that would be fantastic. Doesn't that sound like a fun way to spend your weekend? Plus, you'll get to edit the photos later. Win-win. No, that's not a hobby. That's a project. And projects cost money. Now, two things are going to happen when you use these magic words. When you say, what's your budget? Two specific things will happen. Number one, they will tell you their budget. Or number two, they will tell you they don't have a budget. If they tell you their budget, great. Proceed as you wish if the money makes sense. That's awesome. I used to ask this question when I first started speaking, when I was doing public speaking professionally for the first few years. And the crazy thing is that often the budget was much higher than I was going to charge. I used to be really insecure about my abilities. So when someone would ask me, hey, how much does it cost? What are your rates? Tell me your costs. I'd say, a nickel. I'll fly across the country, create a 3-hour custom teaching for your audience. I'll sleep in a hostel, like a haunted hostel, as long as you'll pay me a whole nickel. Doesn't even have to be shiny. I just would like a nickel. That's what I'm worth.
Oh, a nickel.
But then I started to ask, what's your budget? And the client would inevitably come back with a number that was much higher than a nickel. It really blew my mind. Now, hopefully they have a budget and they tell you what it is when you ask that question. That's the best case scenario, but they might not have one. They might not have any budget, or even worse, they might tell you that they never pay for this kind of work, or that other people give them discounts. Now, this is an interesting negotiation technique, isn't it? Do you see what's happening? Because what's happening is it shames you. One of the greatest struggles that entrepreneurs have is comparison. It's so easy to compare our thing to somebody else's. It's so easy to compare your work to somebody else's. And in this moment, that's what someone is doing to you. They're comparing you to someone else and making you feel ashamed. As if everyone else is generous. Everyone does this for free, but you're the greedy one. Now, it's important to recognize that something very telling is happening right now. Something important is happening. I can't make this point strongly enough. Please, 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 if you only get one thing, hear this. A client who is a jerk during the ask will be a jerk during the task. I could probably do a whole video on just that idea. And I'm going to say it again because it rhymed, and rhymes are fun, aren't they? A client who is a jerk during the ask will be a jerk during the task. If a friend, client, or customer is a jerk during the negotiation, they will be a jerk during the entire project. Don't expect them to magically change into a great client. It doesn't happen that way. Now, if the free project is something you want to do, then by all means, donate your time and expertise. I love that you can use your talents that way. And I think you should. I really do. I think you should support your local church, nonprofit, family members as often as you can. Do free work, but not out of shame or fear. Now, what if you don't want to do the work for free? What do you do in that situation? Well, here is exactly how you respond. You write back or you say to them on the phone, in order to honor and fulfill the commitment I've made to my paying clients, I can't take on any pro bono work. I love doing it when I can, but I don't have the time. Those are the sentences you send back. They're not just asking you to give them something for free. When a friend does that, they're actually asking you to take away time from your paying clients to work on your free clients. And if you do that, you're actually stealing from the people who are paying you. That's terrible. That's how entrepreneurs go out of business. That gets you in a hole. Now, saying yes to the wrong thing is one of the most expensive things that you can do. It really is. Now, there's a key distinction I need to make. I don't want you to miss this. Don't say, I don't have time right now, or I don't have time this month or this week. If you do that, the friend is going to respond, well, what about next month? What about next week? When will you be available? Keep your answer simple and clear and short. I don't have the time. End of the discussion. Now, upon hearing this from you, a good friend will recognize the boundary you just set and will say, oh, hey, thanks for considering it. I really appreciate it. Now, a fake friend will not care that you are too busy and will try to shame you into helping them. That often happens. Don't give in. You do the friendship more damage when you let shame turn your no into a yes. And the bigger issue is that friends should pay full price. Why should we expect a complete stranger to treat us well and pay our fee while people we know get to force us into discounts? Our friends should pay us. Not only should they pay us, they should pay us the most. Friends should overtip. The people who love you should not try to discount your ability. They should be the ones who value it the most. They really should. So don't give up your talent, your time, and your energy unless you want to. And if you do, great. Care about your craft enough to charge for it. Charge for what you do, or you won't get to do it for very long. That's how it works. Now, if you have any questions about this technique, let me know in the comments. I'd love to hear your thoughts. I'd love to help in any way that I can. I think what you do has value, and I want you and other people to see that too. That's my goal with this video. Thanks for watching this today. Hit that bell so you don't miss the next one. Please hit like, and thanks for subscribing to all my videos and to my channel. I'll keep making these videos if you'll keep watching them.